Welcome everyone to today's video. Yesterday's PCIe extension video was only the enablement. I wanted to try something even more esoteric, which is some PCI to PCI Express adapter card for all of our vintage and retro goodness. So this is a not very common PCI to PCIe bridge, of course not passive, but with some hefty bridge IC here on the backside for all the active signal generation and stuff. And I googled this already. This apparently is a reverse capable bridge, so you can use it for either the more common PCI Express to PCI bridge or this not as common PCI to PCIe bridge. Of course, this doesn't necessarily make sense in each and every situation, because of course the bandwidth is way higher here of PCIe, so of course you don't get PCI Express performance from good old vintage silicon. However, I think as far as I read, the bridge is capable of 64-bit and 133 megahertz or something, but not really sure if this cheap thing supports this. Also, of course, you can use this for your vintage Unix, Tinkering, Spark, PowerPC, you name it. So let's plug it in and give it a try and see if it works. Oh, we think it should work. And also, PCI bridges are not uncommon. Many logic boards have those in the north or south bridge. I also have here already VGA cards like this Martrox Palia P619 or something, which also had already such a PCIe bridge. As you can see, PLX or something, so maybe even a predecessor to what we have on the PCB now. For this, let's use nothing less than this trusty Hewlett-Packard thin client here with transmitter efficient that I like in general very much. Nice little box exactly for this kind of tinkering. Actually, the Smartrox card I specifically got for this one for high resolution digital output, but actually this passive cooled card also became too warm to thermal throttle the transmitter efficient though. This of course is already an optional expansion PCI cage. Originally it didn't came with this though. So then our PCIe bridge goes in here like this. As you see, it comes with some low profile adapter to directly mount here low profile cards. While we could add here a PCIe card directly, we will mostly use here this external stuff here as shown yesterday for the Thunderbolt like concept. Just in a decade old x86, actually need to be careful, but there is some clearance, so not to short this on the heatsink. So as a first test, let's see if this sees the bridge like this. I reinstalled the latest Linux 5.1 kernel. That also works again, because previously this was not working anymore, because the last kernel I tested some half a year ago was 4.17 or something that didn't boot on this transmitter efficient, but 5.1 boots again. I suspected this has to do with all the Intel mitigations there for the security vulnerabilities, but whatever. So yeah, it turns still on, so far so good. Then the next step is here to prepare the graphic card nonsense. Latest and cheapest AMD graphics. And remember, I suggest not to hot plug this, because I don't really think it's designed for that. So far so good, we have indeed a PCI bridge here. Then let's plug that in and see if graphic card works. For this, of course, we need some more power than the thin client can deliver. So power supply here, and the ISA thing here for manually switching it on. So we need PCIe power and serial ATA. 2x2, will that be enough, or was it? Oh, I already thought the power supply doesn't have this plug, but here it is, yeah, PCIe. And then serial ATA, just for the 3.3 volt and such as seen yesterday on this USB bridge. And here that plug, and then USB. So because we have here two power supplies, this is of course slightly fragile, if not experimental. So we need to be a little bit careful with the order of which we apply your power. So let's see, this should probably be ATX there powered on here, hard powered on the harness. Maybe we put it so that we see the fan spin. We have indeed fan spin. mostly hidden behind so much tool. You wanna film it and then you short something, but say you have Finspin. Yeah, famous last words indeed, because we don't have Linux booting. Second time works for some magic reason. Let's see what we get here in terms of driver. And yeah, indeed, we have a VGA compatible ATI with a HDMI video controller indeed. And we have indeed the AMD GPU frame buffer. Well, scrolling ridiculously slow because my usual criticism, not the most amazing frame buffer code, as I pointed out already multiple times. So yeah, reading all the high resolution image back and writing it. So that is certainly very interesting. Was not really sure when I was thinking whether such a bridge exists, but this opens quite nice possibilities, not only for hardware driver development and testing, but also all the vintage retro goodness and even Thunderbolt like upgrading your old fashioned low power devices that you might love or don't have more resources to buy new ones. And yeah, I can't, unfortunately, I knew already I can't start X. I knew already I will not be able to start an X server here because this is T28 from 2010. Besides, this build is a little bit borked. Maybe I spend some extra minutes and try to get something working, maybe some old mode setting or something from back in the day. But yeah, as you see, actually, maybe demask. Sometime soon we will also continue the microkernel graphics stuff and hopefully have faster scrolling. Why is this scrolling so excessively? This is slightly funny though. Anyway, yeah, maybe I do some extra minutes, try to build here some mode setting, driver whatsoever, but the problem is this is a super old Xorg server. I probably also should, unrelated, I should anyway spin new T2 builds and use that for testing here on these nice vintage machines. Yeah. As I said previously, the main motivation, of course, not necessarily such a thin client, but also maybe a G4 Cube or Sun UltraSpark and such stuff. So not really sure if that would work in the Cube, maybe, maybe not. Not sure if the Cube will boot without a graphic card, because obviously you need to take out the Apple blessed PCI kind of graphic card out of there. But we have this G5 supported open firmware graphic cards. Would be really interesting to try another month if this works, maybe, maybe not. But basically this allows you to have a poor man's, cheapskates kind of Thunderbolt setup here for external GPUs. Here's the Xorg Linux ecosystem. Could be some incompatibility with latest 5.0 kernel and very old 4, 5, 6, 7 year old Xorg and mode setting driver. Well, there's a cursor, but whatever. So I guess it could work theoretically with a little bit more modern Xorg and Mesa, obviously. I hope you enjoyed this, found this interesting and learned something, and I hope to see you soon for all the next amazing episodes to come.